Hey everybody, it is about that time of year. Winter's gonna be here before I know it, I'm sure. It snowed last year on Halloween, so I'm starting earlier this year. I am changing out the get home bags, bug out bags, summer stuff's going out, winter items are coming in. There's a lot of different scenarios, and it depends where you live, if you're in the city, or if you're semi-rural, or out in the middle of nowhere. That is how you need to get your things together. It's difficult to know if you're going to be able to get out of town or not when you live in a city. The city is, you know, a mile away from us, downtown, or I can go a different direction and we are in the middle of a wooded area. We could go through fields, we could use trails, things like that. So you really have to know your area as far as what you are going to be planning that goes in your bag for yourself and for your family. This is just going to be for myself. So let's start with things that I know I'm going to be putting in my vehicle at this time of year, because we have two seasons in Michigan, which is construction season and winter. That's about it. So these tire repair kits, I have two different kinds. This one here I like because it has this adhesive included in this kit for closing up holes. This other one behind it does not. It just has the plugs and all the other things, but this one actually has the adhesive in it. So it's nice to have both of them because you never know. I mean, I have an SUV type vehicle, so if I ran over some tech strips or something crazy like that, that is a good reason to have lots of things to plug up holes in your tires so you can keep on going. Number one thing is water storage in a vehicle and or in a bug out bag is not easy to do. Trying to carry a lot of water is almost impossible. You actually have to be realistic as far as how much you can carry on your body. Be real. We are not Rambos. Life straws, yes. Practice using them. They are fairly inexpensive and they do last a really long time. So the individual size water from a mud puddle, I'll do it. The other thing I have is these 1 gallon, the gravity fed bags from Life Straw. I have these, I like them as well. I'm gonna try to use the vehicle and get out of town if that's a possibility. That's why I have those here. Or I could use it for a good barter item and get a ride if there's somebody that's not sketchy. So keep that in mind as well. I'm going to bring items like, of course, a small first aid kit. That's all you're going to be able to bring. Yes, my medic bag is usually in my truck, my large medic bag with all the things. But if I can only pick and choose a few things, guess what? I'm going to have some band-aids and some miscellaneous little pieces, and I'm going to go with it and hope for the best and pray. I like these larger Coleman's that you can, the butane propane mix and the attachment that goes on it. My mess kit is in my go bag right now. I did not get that out, so that is missing from here. Different fire starting things, items, you use whatever is best for you. A long-ended, you know, if you're doing a fire out in the middle of nowhere, you want something that you're not going to burn yourself. You don't want to have any problems. A Zippo lighter. This one is windproof. I like this one. Beginning of December gets here because I have my favorite prepper Christmas video that I will be doing a few videos, and I'll probably do a live stream, and I have some giveaways for this year for December. But this is a windproof one that is refillable. And of course, I have tons of the fuel that is needed for that. These little fire starters, you can have your own homemade ones, whatever works best for you. These are just a little, you know, basically cotton rounds. So the other things, this one is, I gave these away last year, Instafire military grade. This is from Shark Tank. This stuff is the bomb diggity, let me tell you. It's smokeless too. So this is something I really love to have, and I have not been able to find any more of it. This was from the Dollar Tree store. years ago, probably. Lights any fire fast. Burns up to 10 minutes, 750 degrees at 30 year shelf life. And there's three of them in this package. An emergency radio, it's got solar, it's crank on the back. You want to have something like that so you know what's going on out there if, you know, there's no communications, no cell phones, whatever. Things to keep yourself warm. Toe warmers. Yes, there's two different brands here. I love this brand better than the others. These are Hot Hands that they sold at Dollar Tree store, which is not bad. This brand is really good. This one is adhesive, which I love. I mean, a lot of them have adhesives on them, but this one actually works really, really well. And there is the two different brands of the hand warmers. These were hard to find, but they are body warmers, and there's two of them in there, and they up to 12 hours, up to 149 degrees in heat. That's pretty darn good. Crank flashlights. That is one thing that is really good to have, because all you gotta do is crank it up and you can use it. Some hand sanitizer. Yes, you want to have some of that. Emergency blankets. Yes, some of those. Duct tape, real good duct tape, not Dollar Tree store duct tape. That stuff is junk. It's you may as well just put a Band-Aid on there if you use the Dollar Tree stuff. Ponchos can be used for many things other than just wearing it. If you need to, you can use it similar to a tarp. These are really large and they're a lot thicker than usual. I found these at a different independently owned Dollar Tree type store. Yes, the tarps from Dollar Tree, they're not the best quality, but guess what? It's better than nothing. These make any kind of a makeshift cover. Headlamps from the Dollar Tree. They're worth $1.50 or whatever, $1.25, $1.50 now. I don't even know. I love this one, of course. It says Army on there. Of course, I'm partial. But it does zoom in, out, and is very bright. I love this thing. I have things that you would normally put in your windows in your house. There's the foam tape. Say you're in your vehicle, it's winter, you're stuck in the snow in the middle of nowhere. The window insulation kit with the sticky tape or your duct tape, whatever you gotta use, you can try to keep your vehicle warmer, or if you're hunkered in a makeshift area that you're trying to survive in until daytime or whatever it is, whatever the situation is, these things can come in handy. They're worth it just to have on hand. They're lightweight. I found these at Ollie's Bargain Outlet, the Copper Fit Knit Cuffed Beanies, and they were $2.99. So I got us two new ones to keep in the vehicle at all times. I do have some Dollar Tree Christmas lights. These are little tiny, the little tiny thin LED lights with Dollar Tree batteries. The only reason I have these is they're not super bright, and if we wanted a little bit of light, say inside the vehicle, or if we were in our makeshift tent with our ponchos on or whatever, we could have a little bit of light in there and not have to have, you know, use any of our like fire starter materials or any of the wood that we have gathered, whatever it is. We want to conserve that. Gloves, I have not found in the Dollar Tree stores. They're really good gloves. They had the two packs. I have some of those that are in my other go bag that I did not dig out, but make sure you bring extra socks as well. So those items are still packed away in there. There's about 50 items here today right now, but you can have as many as you want as long as you think you can carry it. This is a lantern slash fan combo. Food. You want to make sure you got food. You know, you can bring your little snack items, something small, cereal bars, granola bars, something that's got some calories, some carbs, some proteins here and there, but Mountain House is some of the favorites of, you know, just heat up some water, which that's why you have this over here, so that once you get your water, you can have something to eat. These are some of my favorites. I like the chicken Alfredo, the
stroganoff, the pasta, that one's good. The breakfast skillet is good. This one, I have not tried this backpacker one yet, but mushroom stroganoff sounds good to me. Also, a knife. This is one of my favorites. It's a Smith & Wesson, of course. I love it. It's a combo. It's got a glass breaker on there, which could come in handy if you want to get into something and grab some items that have been left behind. You never know. Also, personal protection. Whatever it is that you usually carry, make sure you have it on hand and that you know how to use it. This is just the beginning stage of getting things ready for the vehicle and bug out, get out of Dodge bags, whatever you want to call them. Also, make sure you know if you're in the city, don't have a tactical bug out bag on you. If you want to be a gray man and just blend in with all the other ding-dings trying to get out of town, so make sure you have a plan on where you're going to go, how you're going to go, and hopefully you have things that you need. No, it's not going to keep you alive for 90 days, but hopefully you can get out of the situation that you're in. You don't want to be in an area that is going to be full of people that are going to be doing all kinds of terrible stuff. This is the beginning stage of changing out my truck, emergency items, get out of Dodge bags, go bags, bug out bags, and getting ready for winter. Make sure you have your clothing chosen properly as well. Always try to pack things as tightly as possible and make sure it's as light as possible, because if you're going to be trekking for 20 miles or 30 miles to get where you got to go, you will not be able to carry 50 pounds on your back. Got to be real about the things, stay safe, and try everything out. Go for a walk with your backpack on, see how it feels. Can you go for a mile? Cool. Add a couple more things to it. Can you go 2 miles with that extra weight on there? Cool. Keep going. Keep going. Keep adding. If it's too heavy and you can't even make it down the street for 5 seconds, then you got to change your plans. You got to come up with something different. So these are just my initial items that I am getting together right now to swap out. Hopefully y'all are doing the same thing. Let me know what items that you see that I have today that you would have in your bag as well. And what items would you not have in your bag? Love y'all. God bless. Take care. See you again real soon, and prep up.